What they give you, blood?
3 months, man.
What you doing in here anyway? You ought to be home with your mama. How old are you, boy?
13.
Damn. The bastards must be running out of niggas to arrest.
Going on, everybody. Welcome you guys back to the 24 Karat Black YouTube channel. I'm your man, one half of the brand, Abe.
Cool, KL.
And we just want to wish all the, you know, this is an episode about, you know, all of the mothers. It's Mother's Day, so we want to wish all of you a happy Mother's Day first and foremost.
I'll start. I, like many African-American males, grew up with a female influence. I had two grandmothers, you know, like we all, but like they were heavy influences. My father's mother within my life, very heavy, rest in peace. And my mother's mother, still in my life, you get this sense of like strength and endurance that you don't even really know exists until you become an adult. And so shout out to him, to my wife.
Right, absolutely. Absolutely.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Words can't even express.
There's no word. It's all emotion and feeling with me. I think that it's long overdue. I think mothers deserve, you know, like all the praises, more than just one day out of the year, you know, because I mean, we all come from a woman. And I can say with my grandmother, early on, I seen her strength. She was my mother at times, because my mother had me at a young age. And, you know, just to see how she held the house down and how everything, she orchestrated everything. Everything revolved around her. She was like our sun. She was the solar system, you know, in a sense, because everything lived and kind of breathed based off of her. Everybody went to her for advice. She was the glue, and it was amazing. This woman, my grandfather worked and held the house down, but he did it because, you know, he loved her so much. He didn't want her to work. And, you know, I remember back in the day when I would come home and rest in peace, she passed away in 92, but I would come home from school, little kid, man, and she would always be home cooking meals and cleaning the house, you know, and she always kept me praying, and she taught me the Lord's Prayer. And I remember, you know, she was just so strong, just, you know, just her, just emotionally. And that's when I very first, you know, realized the power of, you know, just a woman in general. I didn't even want to sleep in my own room. I wanted to sleep either in the bed with her and my grandfather, or they would make me a pallet at the bottom of their bed. And I remember when I was probably, you know, I had to be at least 8. I remember crying because I didn't want her to pass away. She wasn't sick or anything, but I realized how much I loved her and needed her in my life. And I was very young, and I remember laying on the pallet and remember just crying because I knew that I never wanted her to leave my life. And just, you know, fast forwarding for me, you know, onto my mother, who, even though she struggled with certain addictions and things like that, she found ways out of no way to make sure that me and my brother had food on the table at least, you know. I mean, she gave us the basic necessities, you know, that she could afford, even through the struggle, you know, even through the struggle with her addiction. With all that, and again, I fell in love all over again with the black woman, just seeing her strength and appreciating all of that. So, you know, that my grandmother, my mother, actually being some of the first examples of how powerful, you know, the black woman is, and you know, and just the women in general, but just speaking from my experience, the black woman. Happy Mother's Day, I love you, and. I'll talk about my queen in a second.
But yeah, but even touching, going a little deeper with what you said about your grandmother and your mother, like you have a brother, I have two brothers, and to see what it's like having kids of my own now, and then trying to wrap my head around a single mother trying to take care of knuckleheads.
Right.
It's like, it's me. I have daughters. Yeah. I have two daughters. And so luckily for me, I have my wife.
Yeah.
And then I had I have my older daughter. Mm-hmm. And her mother is beyond perfect.
Mm-hmm.
So with those two women basically taking care of my kids, it's like, especially the girls, you really get a sign when you become an adult and you realize how important it is to have that other representation.
Right.
Because now that my daughter's a preteen, you have teenagers. Without that woman in the house, or another woman with that powerful presence, you made it like, and so it's like, we don't even think about how important.
Yeah,
they should have a week. It should at least be Mother's Week.
Yeah,
not Mother's Day. That's not
even enough. Yeah, Mother Earth. I mean, Mother Africa. You got to think about how powerful, you know, just the mother is. I mean, and going to my queen, we've been together 20 years. And I can tell you, I wouldn't be alive if it wasn't for her. Because, you know, again, you know, I had my grandmother, then I had my mother. But then, you know, as I grew older and kind of just became my own man, I kind of detached from, you know, being under my mother so much. And I began to venture off into the world. And there were some dangers out there, some pitfalls and some things. During, you know, a certain part of my teenage years, I didn't never see myself ever settling down or falling in love. But she was the only person that caught my attention. And
I can vouch for this too.
Yeah,
and this was my best friend, and she came into life. I ain't never seen this.
Right, man.
Listen to me. This dude knows was so wide open.
Yeah, it was.
You
crazy.
Can drive a Mack truck.
He's not lying, because here's the thing.
We went from hanging out, kicking it every day, rapping freestyles, hanging out, playing sports, man, this girl that I... And I knew about her because she wasn't giving him no play.
Right, not
and
at all.
Always talk about.
Not at all. And the crazy part is
When she did.
It was over.
It was over.
So here's the crazy part, because, again, after my grandmother passed away in 92, you know, I was 10. And that was, like, kind of when my world changed. And my mother, she had to take on everything. Yes, she struggled with addiction. But when I became, you know, able to kind of hold down my own, I started to say, you know what? I want a family. I want love. And it was missing. I want what I was experiencing when my grandmother was alive. I feel like my grandfather, the way he loved my grandmother, I want to be able to give that to someone. And I said I was looking for someone to give, you know, that too. I wasn't just wanting to settle down with anyone, but my queen was the one that I caught. I when I caught eyes with her, she was in a relationship. She gave me no play for a couple years. And then she finally came around and gave me play. She was in a relationship in high school, but when she gave it to me, it was different. I mean, we planned the future and we had kids. And I mean, it was like, I'm going to hold you down forever. And here's the thing. She taught me things about myself. She helped me become more responsible financially, more clean as a man. I mean, just things that I didn't learn. She helped me kind of refine myself. And
think about the importance of having your grandmother in your life.
Yeah.
Your mom was in a place to where she couldn't fully
be
a mom to you.
Right.
But if you didn't have the memories of your grandpa, your mom, and your grandmother, she made you feel, you wouldn't know what it is that you want or desire. I have my mom, rest in peace, same situation, you know, with your mom. But my grandmother lived, what, five doors down from
me? So
that, without her, I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know where I would be. I mean, times when I was hungry and that's where I went for food. If she wasn't there.
Right. And so, and here's
the
thing.
Oh, and then, too, and then my godmom.
Yeah.
Shout out.
Like, yeah. Well, absolutely.
If it wasn't for her,
yeah,
I wouldn't have went to college.
Man.
I probably wouldn't have graduated high school.
Wow.
Just real quick story. All the way up through high school, my senior year, I never had representation. I could go in the classroom, put my head down. Teachers wouldn't say a thing to me. I could disrupt the class. I could come in late. Or I just wouldn't show up. Nobody said nothing. I had my first parent-teacher conference as a senior, and it was with my godparents. But mind you, they don't have my last name. They're my godparents. But they sat in a meeting with all my teachers, had seven of them in high school, it was a seven-period school. And my teachers addressed them as Mr. and Mrs. Long, my last name, and they never corrected them.
Wow.
And to this day, if I run into any of those teachers, they still ask, hey, so how Mr. Long, Mrs. Long doing it?
Wow.
I've noticed a vast difference the very next day of school, how those teachers literally called me out, asking me if I had any questions, did I need to stay out of school for tutoring? If it wasn't for her, none of that would happen. You know what I mean? And so there are heavy influences in your life, whether you know it or not. So my men out there, you got these queens in your life.
Cherish them.
Now, they ain't right for you.
Yeah, they ain't right for you. Then move on.
I mean, but at the same time, if they're doing things right and they are making you better, it's a cliche, but most cliches are true for a reason.
Yeah.
Behind every strong man,
it's a stronger woman. Yeah,
and so,
yeah,
there's things that they endure. I remember the first time I stayed home all day with my kids.
Yeah.
I couldn't wait to go to work. wanted to go to work.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
I mean, you know, and you got to think, they go through these changes with their bodies.
Yeah.
They had these babies that you put in them.
Yeah.
Like, we will never understand.
Even just the transformation
of the body. Some of these women don't get back to the woman that they thought, you know, they were in their early 20s, whatever. Like, some women don't get back to that.
Right,
and so, We gotta appreciate it, man.
Every ounce of it, man. I mean, and to my brothers out there, and to the younger brothers out there, please pay attention to all that the queen is contributing to your life. Pay attention to the details. Whatever she's doing, she's washing your clothes, she's cleaning. Realize how much strength it must take to deal with people like us. You know, like men, we're not perfect. And we make a lot of mistakes, you know, and some of us a lot more than others. And women are able to still stand by
us. They're usually the ones that don't get by your side. Think about
it.
Unfortunately for us, we end up in jail.
Yeah.
Your boys won't come and visit you.
Exactly.
They won't put nothing on your books.
Right.
But your girl will come and visit you.
Your
mother is there and has been there praying for you from the start. Think about that. Let that sink in. And think about all that we do, even as a young pups, for girls.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't care about my ears because I cared about my
ears. Right.
It's because the female cared about my ears.
I didn't go broke from my, when I first got jobs, my McDonald's checks every 2 weeks. I went broke for the females.
Yep.
Just because, you know, I mean, even at that young age.
Think about who you was doing it for.
Yeah, who were you doing it for? Did we need?
And who brought you into this world? A woman brought you into this world.
Yeah, absolutely. We got to understand how significant the woman is and also start make sure we pay that proper appreciation consistently to the woman, and especially the black woman, because in my eyes, black woman goes through so much, you know, and you know, just in general, just the way she's painted in society, the weight that she bears on her shoulder, the pressure, the stresses, all that stuff, on top of us being hard on her in general. Not all black men, because again, we have the good ones that appreciate it and recognize it, but I just want more of my brothers to realize that, you know, we got to step our game up and appreciate these women, man. There's no words.
Right.
There's really no words, really, but we wanted to take a time to use our platform.
Protect them.
To protect, yeah.
I already think about it.
Yeah.
We as black men are low man on a totem pole.
Yeah.
Our black women, by a societal standpoint, are even lower.
Yeah.
Trust me with this.
Yes. Nobody
will come into my kingdom
and
touch mine.
Not at all.
So if all men had the same concept with cherish that black woman, it wouldn't matter what the outside world thought about.
Yeah. All my women, my daughters, I have a 16 and a 15-year-old. My 16-year-old about
and I got a 9mm, a 44, a 38.
I got a machete.
Shotgun.
So check it out. I'm willing to lay my life down without a question.
Not even a thought.
So you don't want to come this way when it comes to threatening, you know, my women, you know. So here's what we're wanting all of our men to recognize this and just step your game up just a little bit if you're not where you need to be and appreciating your woman. We are nothing without our women and our mothers, you know, on this day, because it is Mother's Day, but every woman, of course, you know, they are the ones that give birth to
on this day, if you not around a loved one, but you know one's a mother, wish you happy Mother's Day.
Right. So, you know,
just in general, moving forward, it's not just about this day, it's about women in general.
It's one of,
try to find a woman, give at least one woman a compliment every day.
Yeah, every day. And I tell my queen, every day is Mother's Day for her. It's just like she knows that when I come home from work, you know, I have my things I have to work on, business, you know, I might do gym or whatever the case may be. I have my section of time where I do my stuff, but she knows I'm going to try to do whatever I can to make sure we have our time. Because I know that's what she wants.
I know that house better be clean.
Then that, yeah, the house better be clean.
We're going to cut that out.
We're going to cut that out because they don't want no problems. No problems. But yeah, so, but yeah, man, we appreciate our women and our mothers. And we can't thank y'all enough. We love y'all.
Rest in peace, Betty Mac. Rest in peace, my mom, Bonnie.
Rest in peace. Turn to possible.
From 24 Karat Black, happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day. Love y'all. Peace.